This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you. I'm on a field trip. This is definitely going to be a fun one at that. We're here at Asilomar here in Pacific Grove, California. We're here at the 34th annual EcoFarm conference. So this place is totally crazy. It's like a four-day event with like over, 60 odd different presentations with people that are into creating sustainable food systems and farming systems, and as well as community. So this is definitely a really cool place, lots of really like-minded people. I feel kind of like at home here with the tribe who's all into the similar kind of stuff. So what we're gonna do in this episode today is we're just gonna go around and probably show you guys like me sitting in on one of the conferences. There's many different conferences. I just attended a really cool permaculture one. And I'll probably also in this video go down to the exhibitors and share with you guys some of the cool exhibitors that I like with some products that are gonna help you grow some more food at home. All right, so we're here inside one of the buildings at Asilomar. It's absolutely beautiful. All I know of Asilomar is that my grandma, when I was a young kid, she used to come here for different retreats and whatnot. Like it seemed like she'd come every so often, like every year or something like that. So I'm glad I finally made it here. It's definitely a really nice facility, really excellent place to have this eco farming event. And let's see, I've been to a couple sessions already this morning, and the main part of this conference is, number one, the educational sessions. You know, at some hours or some periods of the day, there's like 12 different sessions that you get to select from. There's ones that are in Spanish, ones that are in English. They range in topics from permaculture for small-scale people growing food, to urban agriculture, to big-scale farms, to, you know, how to dry farm. I mean, all these just different topics, just a wealth of knowledge with all the different presenters that are here at this event. And let's see, the one comment I have of the event, of the presentations I've already went to today, most of the rooms maybe hold about 50 people, and some of the ones that I've attended particularly were actually quite popular. And some of them actually had to turn away people because there was no room for the people to listen to the speaker. And then the other one was a permaculture, of course. The permaculture talk was quite popular as well, so it might be good to, you know, scale the talks if it's a popular subject, to have it in a room that's big enough to hold all the people, you know, so that everybody could get their fill of the information and get the information they need if they want to attend. What we're going to do next is actually take you into another talk. I'll just kind of give you, I was filming while I was in there just to kind of show you guys what it looks like here. It's just a nice homely setting, kind of like reminds you of like a college or something, going back to college. And, you know, just hearing people speak, learning, sitting down, and just a really nice audience. And they are making audio recordings of all these available that will probably be available on the website of the Eco Farm Association at some later time. So yeah, let's go ahead and take you in to show you guys what it looks like inside, what was in the presentations.
To the employer that they have the skills that you want them to have. As far as I know, I haven't looked that deeply.
So besides the educational sessions, another part of the EcoFarm conference is the exhibitors. So I'm here now to share with you guys some of the exhibitors and some of the cool products that they're offering that could allow you to grow more food at home and do it in a more sustainable fashion. Let's head inside and show you some of these exhibitors. All right, so now we're inside the exhibitors marketplace here at the EcoFarm, and there's a lot of different companies offering products. Now, whether they're for like large scale farms or we'll sell to, you know, personal individuals, I'm gonna cover some of the cool ones. So there's a couple good seed companies and a few products that I think will probably be beneficial to use, you know, even in a home garden. So of course, my favorite booths here at the EcoFarm are the seed booths. I love seeds. I love genetic diversity and all the different varieties of crops that you can grow at home. No longer do you have to settle for that orange carrot that you get in the grocery store. I mean, one of the things people don't think about is, yet when we go to the grocery store, you think you have like a wide range. You could get carrots, celery, eggplants. You get all different kinds of things. But in reality, you can only get a few kind of things because you only got one variety of carrots. Some stores have a couple varieties of tomatoes, but it's very limited. If you go to like Johnny's, for example, seed catalog, we got a seed catalog here, and I mean, just counting the different arugulas, right? Here's like a dozen different arugulas you could grow, and each tastes totally different. So yeah, check out Johnny Select Seeds for an amazing seed catalog. Be sure to stay tuned and subscribe to my videos for my upcoming 2014 seed catalog review. Another cool thing here at the event is that they're got a coupon here. I'm gonna share this with you guys, don't tell anybody. This is if you order from Johnny's, you get free shipping. So the offer code is 14-2057 to get free standard shipping. This is gonna save you some money. And this is even, I don't think there's a minimum order on that. So you could order one seed packet, free shipping. And this offer expires 3/25/2014. So yeah, check their website at johnnyseeds.com. So some of the new happenings at Johnny's are, number one, they're really getting into the microgreens. They have a mild micro mix and a spicy micro mix, and they have a whole selection of different microgreens you can grow indoors, yes, even in the wintertime. Another cool thing they have is they have a flyer on heat-tolerant summer crisp lettuces. Many of you guys may not try to grow lettuce in the summer, and I don't usually like to grow in the warm weather because it doesn't perform as well. But now they have a few varieties that are probably do pretty well. They're the Muir, the Magenta, the Tidy, the Concept, the Nevada, and the Cherokee. So try these guys if you want to grow lettuce in the summer. So now we're at the Soil Reef Biochar's booth here. And what they sell are an amendment for your soil. And this, what this stuff is, this is special soil amendment of char for your garden. Now this is not the same as charcoal. This is specially produced using pyrolysis. And why the biochar is so beneficial is because basically it encourages the microbes in your soil. And this stuff really works. They got a little study here that they added 10% biochar to some little potted plants, and they got 25% more growth. So definitely something real cool, and be sure to check my past episodes for a really good episode where I go into the details of what biochar is and, you know, why it is so beneficial. So now we're at the Thorvin booth, and the Thorvin booth, what they do is they do kelp. So this is a clean kelp from like Iceland, and kelp, I've been actually taking kelp for a while now. You can sprinkle it on your foods for a nice salty slash fishy flavor. Another thing to do with the kelp is actually you can feed it to livestock, so your livestock can get the trace minerals and the phytonutrients that are also contained within the kelp. But another thing we could do is we could feed these sea plants or algae to our land plants. So they got the kelp meal, you know, for your plants, which are gonna add in the trace minerals into your soil, also the phytonutrients, and feed the microbial populations in your soil. It'll also promote plant growth. So I definitely recommend you want to look into getting some kelp and adding it to your garden. All right, so now we're at the booth of Wwoof, and that's Worldwide Opportunities on Organic Farms. And what Wwoofing is it's an organization that promotes basically getting people educated and taught in a real world experience, like as an intern on a real organic farm. So you can visit the website wwoof.org to, if you're a farmer, to get interns, right, to have woofers come in to work for you and help you out on your farm, and you could teach them the trade. But also, if you're into gardening or want to learn about farming, this is an excellent way to learn without any prior knowledge, and they'll basically house you and feed you while you're, you know, interning on the farm. So if you want to learn more, check them out at wwoofusa.org. All right, now we're at the Safer booth, and at the Safer booth, they have some Safer products that are for use in organic agriculture to basically take care of all those pests. So no longer do you have to use chemical pesticides. You could use something that's literally safer and organic approved. Now, these are the farming versions, you know, like big gallons, you know, labeled for industrial use. This is the insect killing soap concentrate, and they also have the 3-in-1 concentrate, and this is good for all kinds of different bugs, aphids, whiteflies, all this kind of stuff. Now, the safer products are probably also available at a nursery near you in smaller homeowner sizes, so that now you can use you know, safer products that are organic, so you don't have to spread toxins, put toxins in your food. All right, so here's another really cool product here at the booth of the Eco Weeder, and it's ecoweeder.com, and what this is, basically you put a propane cylinder on this device, kind of looks like, I don't know, one of those metal detectors, but you're not metal detecting. The propane's gonna heat up the little bottom thing, and it's just gonna heat up a plate and basically heat up and literally cook your weeds, like between the cracks or wherever you got them. It just applies enough heat to kill them, and this is not like a fire blower or anything like those things. It's designed and made in Switzerland, so definitely high quality, coming from the European Union. And hopefully one of these days I'll be able to get to try one and show you guys how it works, because man, this thing definitely catches my eye, because I have a lot of weeds coming up and this would be a really cool way to just deal with them instead of having to hand pick them all. Now we're gonna check out another cool booth. It's called RinconVitova, and they have biological controls for pest management. So before you even get out that organic sprays, right? You want to maybe try some of these guys, the beneficial insects. I mean, in nature, there are beneficial insects and there are natural controls in nature that control, you know, the bad bugs and there's the good bugs and all this kind of stuff. But when man gets involved and starts spraying pesticides, it just wipes out everything. There's no good bugs to, you know, kick ass over the bad bugs. So what we're going to show you guys next is some cool ideas and controls that they're offering here to provide you some solutions in your garden. So what they're doing here is beneficial insects, and let me show you guys these. For many of you guys, you might not have a problem with flies, but if you got animals like horses and whatnot, you know, you might have a lot of flies. And what they got here is basically the fly pupae. This is basically the flies leave a little egg thing and then it hatches, and all these little fly eggs on this paper here have been infected with the fly parasite that actually is like living inside the fly egg, that's then gonna hatch, turn into its own larvae and eat the fly larvae, and then eject itself out, hatch as a little, you know, parasite fly, and then go find more fly larvae to basically lay their eggs into. So that's how these biological controls work. We're just using nature and concentrating, you know, the beneficials in a, you know, a little bit higher than normal amounts, because, you know, many racetracks make higher than normal amounts of manures. Another thing they have that's really cool are these guys. These are ladybugs. You're thinking, John, what, those don't look like ladybugs? Ladybugs are those like little like red things with the spots on their backs, right? That eat like the aphids and the white flies. Well, this is actually a different kind of ladybug. There's like over, I don't know, 80, 85 different kinds of ladybugs out there. And this is a special kind. These small ones in the little jar here, what these do is they eat hard scale. So actually in my greenhouse now, I actually got some hard scale, and it might be good to let some of these guys go, and it'll just rip the tops off the scale and eat them. So I mean, this is the kind of insect warfare I like. You know, you don't even have to spray anything, you don't have to do anything. You can just get some beneficials and put them to work in your garden, and guess what? You don't even gotta pay them. The next beneficial insects I wanna show you guys are these guys right here. These are actually called the lace wings, and the lace wings eat the bad bugs, and they're shipped like this actually in the little comb thing. The lace wings will actually eat themselves, so they put one egg per little comb thing you guys could see in there. And if we look close, we might be able to see them. You know, a few of them are actually alive and already walking around, but most of them, they're just the eggs. And this is how they ship them to you. And you actually need to order these and get them and then put them out, because they have a very short shelf life, right? These are all live, living insects in here, and you don't want them just sitting in a box on your porch for a while. I think that happened to me once, actually. So besides just the beneficial insects, they also have insect traps. So, you know, sticky traps and all this kind of stuff, and to basically, the sticky traps will attract and stick the bad insects and the good. But aside from that, they have insect bait traps. So the one that I really like here is actually this guy. It's a reusable bait trap for ants. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna unscrew this guy here, and you're just gonna mix up a solution in the bottom here of like the sugar, water, and boric acid with the right proportions. Screw this on the top, take it to where you want it, flip it over, and it's gonna be like that automatic dog water feeder thing, you know, so your water never runs out for your dog. It's kinda like that. It just lets the stuff go down, and then the ants will kinda come in here and basically eat the stuff and then take it back to their hive or their nest or whatever and get that queen, so that they'll wipe out the colony. The cool thing about this is that because of the shape, it will not allow the evaporation to occur, because it is shaped this way. It's gonna basically evaporate unto itself and then basically drip back down. Plus, this is reusable. I mean, literally, you buy this thing once, it'll probably last for for many years to come. Now, besides just the beneficial insects, these different kind of traps and baits, they also have some cool seeds and insect attractants so that you can attract beneficial insects into your garden. So the last thing we're gonna share with you guys today are some seeds, and they got some special seeds here. This is actually an insect flora seed mix. So what these are, you could plant these seeds and it'll attract the beneficial insects to your garden. These are the special seeds and the special plant varieties are gonna attract the beneficials. So definitely like this a lot. Now besides just the insect attracting seeds, they also have an insect food that you can purchase. So you're gonna purchase this insect food, dilute it down to the proper ratio, not too sticky, but just right, and it's gonna attract the beneficials into your garden because the beneficials are gonna go for the food here, and then once they get this food, hopefully they're gonna look for the other food, like the other bad insects in your garden. Aside from that, they have a couple other unique seeds that I actually haven't seen before. This is actually just simply labeled the roadshow. So what is a roadshow? Well, these are special seeds that you just plant in your roadway, like if you have a gravel road, a dirt road, and you always get dust flying up. This will basically act as a ground cover and hold the soil in place, and also maybe have some beautiful flowers that you could drive over too. And then finally, they got this one here that I've never heard of before. If you got gophers, you might want to try this stuff. It's simply labeled gopher stopper, and it's in an old ball jar with a rusted top, so it's definitely probably been around the block. But they say that if you plant these guys, there's some coumadins in there that the gophers don't like, and the gophers will, you know, avoid the area. So I don't know, it's definitely worth a shot. If you're interested in any of these products or to learn more about the insects, they have a really good website that is a wealth of knowledge. It's called RinconVitova.com. All right, so I've got to spend the whole day here at the EcoFarm. Definitely had a fun time, and definitely if you're into sustainable farming, creating sustainable food systems and want a community, this is definitely it. You're gonna wanna check it out in future years to come. I definitely recommend it. Just the short time that I had to spend here has been totally amazing. You can learn more at eco-farm.org to learn more about the ecological farming organization and their work, as well as the EcoFarm conference. Now, it doesn't matter if you're not like a farmer, like farmer. You know, even people that are just home gardeners, there's a lot of information here. Like every hour, there's like, I don't know, almost a dozen different classes you could go to, or every session there's a dozen different classes you could go to, and there's even ones in Spanish and ones for big producers to small producers, the ones on permaculture that I liked about urban farming. There's always something to do, and there's so many people to network here with. I mean, the people attending are like the whole gamut, from like commercial producers to distributors to like people that are conventional farming that are gonna move towards the ecological farming, to home gardeners, to urban homesteaders, to people that are chefs and wanna learn more about their food. Basically just bringing food justice and, you know, getting food and growing food in a more sustainable way than it is currently being done. And I'm glad all you guys that are hopefully my normal viewers are currently growing your own food, because that's the number one step you can take to make food more sustainable, is to grow it locally, grow it yourself, and eat it out of your own garden. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on growing.